Good morning, students. Today I will be taking Maths, Chapter 9, Multiplication and Division of Fractions. Today's topic is Problem Sums on Division of Fractions. So here I am giving you first example. If the cost of 314 kg of sugar is rupees 106.5. So you have to find the cost of 1 kg of sugar. So for this, what you have to do, how to write it? Cost of 314 kg of sugar, that is rupees 106.35. Therefore, cost of 1 kg of sugar, that is, you have to divide. To find for 1, you have to divide. So this is the total one, so you are dividing by 314. So second step is multiply and plus, you will get 533 divided by 5. So here division sign is there, so multiply and plus, you will get 13/4. So you will write here same thing here. Now multiply and this 4 will come up and 13 will come down. Now here you can see this number 533 will go by 13. So 13 into 13, 13 into 41 is 533. So here I have shown you how to divide. So 533 is divided by 13. So 13 4 is 52. Here you will get 1 and 3 will come down. 13 into 13, so you will get this 41. So here 41 is here. Now you, what you will do, 41 multiplied by 4, you will get 164. And underneath 1, 5 into 1. So 5 into 5. So now since this is greater than this, so we will divide. So when you divide this by 5, 164, if you divide by 5, so you will get 32/5. So in the end, what you will do, hence the cost of 1 kg of sugar is rupees 32/5. Now I will show you one more example. Now student, we will do second one. A bag of salt weighs 2 1/4 kg. So one bag that weighs 2 1/4 kg. If 41/2 kg of salt is to be put in such bag, how many bags will be required? So here we are getting total weight is this much and one bag that weighs this much. So we have to find how many bags are there, how many bags will be required to fill this amount of salt. So for that we have to write total weight of salt, that is total 40.5 kg. Weight of salt in one bag, that is 2 1/4 kg. Number of bags required to fill the salt. So how many bags will be required? So what we will do, we will divide. So 41/2 divided by 2 1/4. Multiply and plus, you will get 81/2 divided by 4 to the 8, 1, 9/4. Then 81/2 multiplied by this 4 will come up and 9 will come down. So now here 81 is here and 9 is here. So 9 1 is 9, 9 9 is 81. 2 1 is 2, 2 3 is 4. This is numerator one, so 9 to the 18 and below is 1 into 1. So that is 1. No need to write 1 here. So 18 bags. So in the answer what you will write? The required number of bags is 18. Now student, I will show you one more example. Now student, this is the third example. Here if a car travels 283.5 km in 4 2 by 3 hours, how far does it go in 1 hour? So we have to find for 1 hour. So you have to write like this: distance covered by a car in 4 2 by 3 hours is equal to 283.5 km. Distance covered by a car in 1 hour. So what we have to do? We have to divide. So here you have to multiply and add. So you will get 567/2 divided by 3 4 12 plus 2 14/3. So
In a bracket is a electrolyte kilometer here.
Then again 567 by 2. Now this divide will change into multiply. So multiply and 3 will go up and 14 will come down. Now what you will do, you will multiply the top one. So you will get 1701 and down one, this is denominator part, 2 multiplied by 14, that comes to 28 kilometers. Now we have to divide this one. So I have shown here the division one. So 28, 6 are 168. If you subtract it, you will get 2 and 1 will come down. Since this is 28 and this is 21, so 28 zeros are 0. So 21 will be the remainder. So you have to write like this, 60 will come here, 21 here and 28 will come here. Now we will see here, this is 21 and this is 28. So this will go by 7. So 7 3 are 21, 7 4 are 28. So answer will be 63 by 4. So 63 by 4 kilometer. So in the end you will write, hence the car travels 63 by 4 kilometer in 1 hour. That's all for today. I hope you have understood. Thank you.